Alan Dershowitz, Harvard Law professor and the author of a great book. It is called The Case Against Impeaching Trump. He joins us live from Martha's Vineyard. Professor, you know, people are hearing this exchange that was recorded secretly by Mr. Cohen, and they're going, I don't know exactly what's going on. You've heard it. Is anything illegal? Have any crimes been committed in what we have heard so far?
Not even a close question. There's no crime. This was a conversation between a lawyer and a client that should never have been heard, even if, and the tape is unclear, Trump raised the word cash. There was then a discussion, and the lawyer said, no, no, no. And President Trump said, no, we'll do it by check. Lawyers and clients have those conversations all the time. I've had conversations like that with clients. The end result is cash was not used, no payments were made. The context of the tape all suggests that the president wanted it to be papered. They wanted it to be a corporation, not just a payment. He wanted to make sure it was done right. He wanted to make sure it was done with records. And so I think the big picture is no crime. It sounds like Cohen is not as loyal to the president as he once was. It also suggests that this conversation never should have been heard by any of us.
Right.
And Cohen should not have recorded a conversation. You know, you trust your lawyer to have a discreet conversation so that you can lay out all the possibilities and then decide what to do. The end result is no payments were made, no cash was given, and so this is a big deal about nothing.
How does an attorney get away with this then? What happened to client-attorney privilege? Are you allowed to just tell everyone what your client told you in confidence? Isn't that illegal, or do you lose your license? What's the consequence for that?
If, in fact, this material was originally leaked by Cohen when it was still privileged, remember, a judicial officer found it to be privileged, it then was leaked. Only after it was leaked did Giuliani waive the privilege as to this in order to protect the privilege as to any other possible conversations. If Cohen is the source of the leak, he has a serious problem. But we don't know who the source of the leak is.
Right.
That's
right.
One of the things I think we have to get to the bottom of.
Alan, are you? I was under the belief, and I think you were too last night, that Rudy Giuliani could have stopped it and didn't.
Well, he obviously had a tactical decision to go the way he went, that is to waive the privilege and to make a statement as to what's on the tape. He could have taken a different tact. He could have said, this is outrageous, and he could have sought a hearing to determine who leaked it and to have it suppressed. But he didn't take that tact because he believes that the tape is exculpatory and helps Trump. Right. I think reasonable people could disagree about that, and we'll never know for sure what the words are until we have a forensic analysis. The other key thing is that the tape ends abruptly, which means that Cohen either erased what he didn't want anybody to hear afterward, or he cut it off abruptly because he didn't want anybody to hear it. A forensic expert can determine why it was cut off so abruptly and give us a better sense of what the words are from both sides.
Well, here are the words. The president's legal team has just put out their transcript, and it reads like this. Michael Cohen says, and I spoke to Alan about it. When it comes time for the financing, which will be, and then Donald Trump says, wait a sec, what financing? And Michael Cohen says, well, I'll have to pay him something. And Donald Trump says, don't pay with cash, check. And Michael Cohen talks over the president, and says, no.
Mm-hmm. Well, let me be very clear, first of all, I am not the Alan. It's a different Alan we're talking about. Number two, you know, it remains to be seen. I had a case just like this some years ago where the issue was whether the cop said it's done on wiretaps or it's not on wiretaps. And the Court of Appeals listened to the tape about 20 times, finally ruled in my favor. This is an issue for forensics. But I think whatever was said, the context strongly suggests the president wanted it to be done through a corporate structure. Corporations don't send cash. Corporations send checks or wires. So the context supports the president's view, regardless of what the words themselves say. But in the end, this was a lawyer conversation. And in the end, the president decided to do it the way the lawyer wanted to do it. And it wasn't done at all. So there's no crime here. There's no impeachable offense here. And if you read my book, you'll see that you can't impeach a president just because you don't like a conversation he may have had with his lawyer.
Right. And it's a candidate, Trump, and he's businessman Trump, whatever you thought before. He isn't President Trump. Michael Avenatti came in and said, Mr. Davis is a good lawyer, but his client Cohen is not innocent, nor is he a victim. He's a co-conspirator, dishonest thug who continues to refuse to come clean and do the right thing. They are playing you and aiming for a pardon. Where is the rest of the evidence and tapes? The answer to that is Lanny Davis says more tapes to come. Real quick on Avenatti's comments.
Well, you know, he is representing a client, and people will have to judge whether he is doing a good job or not. But, you know, one has to know whether he was the source of the leak as well, because he claimed to have known that there were 12 tapes before that fact was known publicly.
Right.
So he had some questions to answer. Look, I don't want to get into a personal thing with Avenatti, because he's not a central character in this. The central lawyers now are Rudy Giuliani and Lanny Davis, both excellent lawyers with long experience and long histories, and both of them have strategic decisions that they've made.
Yep.
And I'm not in a position yet to judge the strategic decisions, because we don't know all the facts. So
all
the first step is forensic analysis. The second is context. But I think it's clear no crimes were committed on this particular thing.
And if you have Alan Dershowitz in your Secret Santa, don't get him a plaque. He's got plenty. Look behind him.
All right.
Oh, my goodness. How many awards do you have?
That's great. Alan, thank you very much for joining us live.